Over 300 teams start the season with hopes of making it to the NCAA tournament, but only 64 lucky teams received an invitation. These teams start their journey down the road to the Final Four in today's game between the Iowa State Cyclones and the San Diego State Aztecs.
This place is rocking and rolling, baby!
The Aztecs are in for what should be an easy one tonight, Dick, but how do they stay interested enough to win this game?
Interested enough, Brad. They still have to do the following things. Number one, the point guard has to be the leader out there. He's got to be the coach on the floor. Second, take care of the rock. No turnovers, baby. Turnovers only lead to easy scores the other way. Thirdly, get busy battling for the boards. Winning teams always rebound well.
Well, Dick, let's get this one started and see what happens. On the dribble, gives it up. Gibbons, pump fakes. The point guard handles the feed. And up and in and out. Price receives the pass. Both teams looking to get things going here. They go into the low block. Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket, not quick enough. And a great reaction by the defensive post player.
Gave it up. And he'll kick it back outside. Foul charge. Oh, and look at the crowd, and look at the reaction.
I tell you, the whole fans are going crazy. There's jubilation.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Kicks it out.
Gotta take some flight on the defensive end.
Way off target. On the outside. Trying to feed the low block. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that block shot.
I want to thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. I'm Brad Nessler. Looking for contact. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. Moving it around the perimeter. On the dribble, gives it up. He shoots from the angle. Knocks it down. Chase fakes the shot. He looks at the hoop. Tries for two.
Wow, what a super job of running his man into the screen for that sweet jumper.
Gave it up. Searcy receives the ball. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
From three-point range.
I wish somebody would knock down a jumper. Hey, that guy had 1,400 on his board. And look at him running out there like a wacko. Oh, man. Look at that wacko.
He was guarding him tightly, and then he went for the steal. An unsuccessful attempt resulting in a personal foul.
That's why some coaches don't like it when players go for the steal. They end up with fouls or in foul trouble.
Goes up for two. Perfectly executed. Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, both teams appear to be really focused as they return to their benches. This is it for one of these teams, and as you guys frequently say, it's do or die, guys.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Pull-up jumper from way out. Off the rim and no good.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box. Great play to take that to the basket.
Five-second call approaching. For two. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
At some point, his team is going to have to step up and play at his level. He's carrying them right now.
Thinks about the shot. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
He stole the ball. Great pressure there.
Fantastic ball pressure. The pressure got to the ball handler, and he lost it.
That one puts the personal in personal. Picks up the foul.
I tell you, poor play defensively. Look at the facial expression. Coaches love it when their team gets to the free throw line. It's an opportunity to put points on the board and potentially get the opponent in foul trouble.
second one is good. Searcy handles the pass. There they come with a double team to stop it.
We'll get a better look on the replay. Brad, if they were smart, they'd go 2-for-1.
Way out on top, controlling the ball. They're not doing a very good job of finding the hoop tonight, Dick.
Well, they're not working the ball around. They're not finding the open man. Trying to go inside.
And they do. They got on the low block. Nice defensive rebound. They cleared ahead in transition.
Men have got to get out and fill the lanes, Brad.
There's a tough shot and one.
He wanted that one, baby. He says you gotta foul me harder than that.
The Cyclones will step to the line for the first time. Makes it.
Spacing. Double team now, bad angle.
Great steal. I think the pressure was just too much.
Awesome ball pressure. It is too much for him, and he lost possession.
Way off target. At the end of the first half, the Aztecs are behind by 3. It's been a tight one thus far, Mr. Vitale. What play do you think set the tone here tonight?
Hey, as we take a look at this dunk, Brad, I have to say nothing gets a college crowd into a game like the dunk. This one's certainly no exception, baby.
Well, Dick, let's see what's in store for us here in the second half. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys?
Thanks, Aaron. Dumps it in. He got the steal. The pressure got to the ball handler.
Tremendous pressure, just enough to force the steal.
Tough spot defensively in the post, but he got the steal.
Wow, I could have made that steal. He telegraphed that. He was the Marconi guy. What a poor pass.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. And he missed. He stays in control until they regroup the offense. Jump hook from the low block. In and out. The point guard takes the pass. Regroup. Trying to draw some contact. That comes off. Might have been some contact on the shot. Trying to feed inside. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on the post play.
Puts it up, looking for contact. Drops the bucket despite the harm. On the dribble, gives it up. Unloads. Off the rim and no good. He keeps his dribble as they reset. Here he comes defensively on him on the low block, Dick.
I'll tell you, three-quarter position, trying to deny, but then he does a great job of post position and spreading his body and getting the ball.
Nice steal there, but the offense gets the ball back.
Nice fake.
Trying to come up with a steal, and they do.
There's a steal.
The shooting guard receives the ball. Patience with the ball as the offense regroups. A high screen with a bucket. Off the rim and no good.
A Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Showing maturity by waiting for the O to regroup. Tries for two. He's just not.
Ooh, look at the shot block, but he got some contact. Nice hops.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, an emotional message from both benches. Let's play our game. That's what got us here. And more importantly, let's believe in one another. Guys?
Thanks, Aaron. This place will be in complete chaos if this defense can get a stop right here. Decided against the open post and reverses the ball. Big finish coming here, partner. I'm not going anywhere.
In close games like this, Brad, offensive and defensive execution is very important.
We got a timeout on the floor, and with that, let's go courtside to Aaron Andrews.
Well, at this point in the game, it's about being on the same page. Each player should know what the objective is for the upcoming possession. Offensively, you must know who the number one option is, while defensively, the type of defense you're going to play or whether to foul. Time is of the essence, Brad.
And I think she's right about that, Richie. Right now, his team in front by two. Get inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
He's money with a shot. Change things up a little bit, Dick.
We'll see what they come up with, Brad.
It's a one-point game.
1 point usually means free throws, Brad.
Dumps it in. The power forward receives the pass for two.
I tell you, really, a part of the offensive plan is to teach your post players to utilize that up and under move, and he does it exceptionally well.
He went for the steal in the post, and he missed it, Dick.
Oh, I'll tell you one thing. What a poor job defensively. He gambled.
Searcy is feeling good.
Hey, Brad, I love players that play with emotion. That's why I love the college game.
The three. He drains it. Looks like we're ready to step back out onto the court. Shot clock is dead. Olsen handles the feed. He throws it up from downtown.
Timeout on the floor. It's a close one. The trigger fingers are getting itchy, baby. This one's too close to call.
Try and surprise the opposition with a little change here, Dick.
That might not be a bad idea.
Now trying to feed the low block.
There's the trap.
Hard foul. There's a look at the timeout situation.
Hey, some people like to call it game management, Brad. Knowing when to use timeouts is an art. Also, team fouls. Defending without fouling is always important.
The center gets the ball. Rims out.
The more possessions you create, the better your chances.
Well, Dick, the shots seem to be dropping for him right now.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. They're dropping, and you better have good productivity out of your front court. When you have that balance inside-outside, you got a great chance to win. And you have to have post players that are going to make big plays.
Dick, I think the better team won. We can say that, and it's heartbreak for the other club, but you know, you've got to win it and keep on going to get to that final Monday night in April.
Well, I tell you, they won this game, Brad, when you look at it and analyze it, because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
Mr. Vitale, how about that State Farm drive of the game?
Oh, Mr. Nestler, this one's superb. The ability to get close enough to the basket and then have the presence of mind to finish off the great play. Wow, what a play.
The Aztecs came, they saw, and they conquered their first-round foe, Dick.
I tell you, Brad, watch out for this team because the coach has these kids playing.